Alright, welcome back. In today's tutorial, we're going to actually use this derivative model. And let's begin by typing in a new expression. And let's say that expression is 2x plus 1 over x. This here is the seventh expression in the list. So back up here, let's switch this to a 7. And let's say we wanted to know what the derivative was or is when the x value is 1. So let's set this here to 1. And here we see that the derivative or the slope at that particular point is 1. And then here we have the tangent line. But let's say they wanted to know what the question was, what is the equation for that tangent line? Well, we can do that here. So let's create another point at that same location. Well, let's just call it 1, 3. Or let's continue to make it dynamic. So let's just make it x sub 1, and then we'll keep the y sub 1. So basically we have two points in the same position. So what I'm going to do here is now turn on the label, and let's do some formatting. I want the label to be at the bottom, and let's change it to black. And let's see, what else can I do? And let's see for the label here, let's see if I can make it bigger, I guess. Oh, that's way too big. So let's try maybe 5. No, let's try 2.5. All right, we'll do 2.5. I think that's pretty good. All right, so we have that. Also, let's see if I can make this thicker. So let's change the contrast. There we go. So we can see that better. All right, so for this label, let's say we're going to use the point slope formula. So y minus, well, I want to use the value that y sub 1 represents. So I'm going to place the dollar sign here, a curly brace, type the letter y, use the underscore key, which is shift, and the key to the right of the 0, and then press 1. So now we see that instead of writing y underscore 1 on the screen, it writes a 3 for the y sub 1 value, and we see here that y sub 1 is 3. Now, placing the equal sign, I want to show what the value of m is, so I'm going to place a dollar sign, curly brace, and then the letter m, and then right curly brace, m represents the slope, and here we see a 1 is showing, as we see here. Then I want to use just a regular parenthesis. I just want to show the x, and then I want to show what x sub 1 contains. So again, that's going to be dollar sign, curly brace, x under bar or underscore 1, and then the curly brace to the right, and then I want to close that off with a regular parenthesis. And here we see that x sub 1 is showing 1, and we know that from the point it's also showing 1. So now we have a dynamic model where I can actually now drag the point, and let's say I drag the point to 2. It's probably hard, there we go, so at 2. So when the x value is 2, I see that the equation for the tangent line is y minus 4.5 is equal to 1.75 times the quantity x minus 2. All right, well, that sums up this tutorial by ajspeller.com. If you like it, please like it. And as always, thank you for watching.